It's so loud upstairs. They really are loud upstairs. Woo! Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
This LC circuit is a circuit with a capacitor, an inductor, and a switch. Before time t equals zero, the switch is open and has been open for a long time. And the capacitor has energy stored in the electric field between its charged plates. At time t equals zero, the switch is closed and remains closed. Bo, tell me what we know about the initial current in the circuit, the current at time zero.
Well, the switch has been open for a while before the switch is closed, and there is an electric potential difference between the plates of the capacitor. So before the switch is closed, the current in the open circuit is zero. After the switch is closed, the inductor opposes changes in current in the circuit. So because there was no current in the circuit before the switch is closed, right when the switch is closed, the current is initially zero. But then after time t equals zero, the current does increase, but I don't know what happens after that.
Does it reach a steady state current like an inductor resistor circuit?
Billy, an inductor capacitor circuit does not reach a steady state current like an inductor resistor circuit.
But then what happens?
We are about to figure that out.
Great.
The current passing through the inductor is caused by charges leaving the capacitor. Therefore, as current through the inductor increases, charge on the capacitor decreases. The current moving through the inductor causes a magnetic field in the inductor. Therefore, as the magnitude of the electric field in the capacitor decreases, the magnitude of the magnetic field in the inductor increases. Once the charge on the capacitor is completely discharged, the charge on the plates of the capacitor equals zero, the inductor has its maximum magnitude magnetic field, and the current through the inductor is at its maximum magnitude. Current continues to flow and builds up charges on the plates of the capacitor. However, the orientation of the positive and negative plates will be reversed, and the current is decreasing. Eventually, the current through the inductor will reduce to zero, and charge will be at a maximum on the plates of the capacitor.
But the charges on the plates of the capacitor are reversed from where they were when the switch was closed, right?
Correct.
Does that mean the whole process repeats itself only in reverse this time?
Yes, it does.
It's simple harmonic motion.
Simple harmonic motion.
It does not look simple.
A horizontal mass spring system is a good analogous situation. As the mass oscillates back and forth, the mechanical energy goes from being elastic potential energy to kinetic energy to elastic potential energy to kinetic energy. Just like in the inductor capacitor circuit, the energy in the system goes from being electric potential energy stored in the electric field of the capacitor to magnetic potential energy stored in the magnetic field of the inductor to energy in the capacitor to energy in the inductor. They are both examples of simple harmonic motion.
I still don't think it looks simple.
Yeah, well, it's not damped harmonic motion because there is zero resistance in the wires of this LC circuit. Resistance in the circuit would dissipate energy from the circuit. And it's not complex harmonic motion because there's only one capacitor and one inductor and not some complicated combination of multiple inductors, capacitors, and resistors. So yeah, an ideal LC circuit is simple harmonic motion.
Okay, yeah, I got it. Thanks.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.